All right, guys and gals, let's do it. So for starters, you can visit the WordPress.org site if you want to, I guess, meet WordPress, but you don't need to be on this site and you don't need to click download WordPress either because our web host of choice today, HostGator, has unlimited copies of it and it'll set up WordPress for us. But sometimes I like clicking showcase just to see who else is using WordPress, like Bloomberg, Angry Birds, and the Walt Disney Company. All right. So we're going to visit HostGator in a second to see what they're all about, but I'm also going to bring in our handy stopwatch so we can see how getting web hosting and getting a domain name if you need it takes about as much time as it does to check our emails, which for me is 4 minutes. All right, so let's click start and we'll keep an eye on that as we go through. First up is to visit HostGator at www.hostgator.com. All right, and we're also going to keep track of how many different snappies we see throughout the tutorial. That's snappy right here. So I choose HostGator because they're always the first to come out with new products like these. They have award-winning live chat support up here, and you pretty much get more features than you could ever need to try out on your new blog. You'll never run out of new things to play with. So first step is to click Get Started Now right here. And we're gonna get the Hatchling plan today because it's the most basic, cheapest plan. One step up would be the baby plan though, and that's just good if you want to run unlimited sites, but the Hatchling plan is perfect if you want to run one WordPress site or blog, same thing. And we can see that it starts at $3.95 per month, but that's just what the general public pays. You're my audience, so we're always going to get better stuff, and I'll show you how to get a special discount in 1 second. I just want you to know that you can also click compare all plans, and you get this really epic detailed list from HostGator. Showcasing what their three most popular plans, Hatchling, Baby, and Business, come with. Things like a free $100 credit to try Google AdWords or Yahoo Bing. And most importantly, Hatchling comes with amazing WordPress hosting right here. All right, so that's all we need today, but this list is obviously pretty cool, just so you know about it. All right, so now it's time to see how to get our discount. This is just an example from a previous video tutorial that people followed. But what I'm going to do is leave you a link like this one beneath the video. Believe me, not everyone sees or finds it, but it's going to say something like get biggest discount at HostGator. And then you just click through it and the discount will be applied automatically. So already we're going to get the hosting down to $3 a month, that same amazing Hatchling hosting. And it also gets a domain name thrown in and custom email thrown in so you don't have to use your Hotmail anymore. All right, so the discount will be applied automatically and I may earn a small credit if you sign up through my link. That comes at no cost to you. So big thanks for helping me, by the way. All right, so now we'll click on Get Started and we're gonna go to the HostGator order form, so you're in the right place. Step one, we just need to choose a domain. So enter your new domain name if you wanna register a new one. If you need help with any ideas, let me know in the comments. This part's really fun, but I already found the perfect one and I already bought it. So I'm gonna click, I already own this domain. I'm gonna enter in my WordPress blog tutorial, if I could spell. All right, not bad. And I'm just gonna choose the .com here. We don't need to get any of the other extensions because I'm not worried about copycats at this point. But the .com is the best. If you get the .net or the .org or something, it's not gonna hurt your site. People just think of the .com right away, so I like that. In step two, it's time to choose a hosting plan. Just make sure you have Hatchling selected. And then for billing cycle, we can see that 12 months is a really good price. It's actually the lowest price right here. But even more importantly, perhaps, 12 months is the ideal amount of time to make your blog a success and make some money from it, or move on to another online adventure, but it's important to give your blog or website a chance at success. And it looks like even HostGator knows that. So we're gonna choose it for $2.58 a month. That would just be $3 if you get a domain name too. Next, choose a username and a password and come down. Enter your billing info in step three. So I had autofill take care of that. In step four, make sure to uncheck all the additional services. You can add them later, but we don't need them at the moment because we want to pay the least amount possible. And in step five, we're done. All right, so it's going to be $31 if you just get the web hosting, or $36 if you get the domain name. That domain name will just be $5 a month, which also is a discounted price. All right. So these are both insanely amazing deals, and you have my personal word that these are actually the best deals available today. It might expire in the future. If it does, just let me know in the comments and I'll help out. But for now, let's keep moving. Check this box and then proceed and click checkout now. Congratulations and welcome to the HostGator family. When you see this screen, it's now time to check our inboxes. Okay, so we're in our email now, and I want you to look out for two emails that HostGator will send you, which will help you do the next two steps we need to do right now before we install WordPress. All right, and I'm sorry for going 34 seconds over. Greg owes you 34 seconds, redeemable, however you want. All right, so the first email to look out for is billing. All right. And if you don't see these emails, just ask HostGator's award-winning live chat. They'll send them over manually. So open up billing. And the first step we need to do and need to know how to do is just to log in to that place we were before where we got the congratulations, welcome to the HostGator family message. Get back there because that's also where we install WordPress. And I closed all my browser tabs, so we need to see how to get back there. All right. So to do that, we just click on this link that says HostGator billing portal, and then log in with the information from that billing email. So that first next step is done. You now know how to get back to your HostGator customer portal, which is they also call it the billing portal. Customer portal sounds a little better, but this is where you do pretty much everything in terms of managing what you just set up. You can see I have a lot of hosting packages, and this is also where we install WordPress. All right. So let's click on hosting and get ourselves to the right place. But what we need to do now, the second thing we need to do is go back to our inbox and open up the no reply email. All right. And this email contains first name server and second name server, which are two important pieces of information we need to connect our domain name with our hosting. Everyone needs to do this step, especially if you registered your domain name somewhere like GoDaddy or Namecheap. Just log into those registrars and follow the instructions or ask their live chat where to put your first name server and second name server, and then make sure to save so your domain name points to your hosting. All right, this is a necessary step. And I'd show you how now, but this is a HostGator tutorial. So if you really want, I'll let you know in the comments how to do that at a place like GoDaddy or Namecheap. For now, we're going to move forward and enter the first name server and second name server at HostGator. Should take us about a minute. So let's continue, all right? Continue. Okay, so we're just gonna write these down or copy them in our case, it's a little easier. Highlight, right click, copy. And I'm gonna remember that the other one is just 9.8 instead of 9.7. Come back to your HostGator customer portal, and then let's click on domains at the top. And what we're gonna do, this is just an example. You'll see your domain name right here. You're gonna click on the gear. All right, and then where it says name servers, you're gonna click change, and you're just gonna write over these two name servers. All right, so delete it, and then right click paste, and then write in the new one as well. All right, so that one was just an 8. And then once that's done, you're just gonna click save name servers, and you're good to proceed. Good job. All right, I think we nailed that one at 1 minute. Great job. So let's come back to hosting. All right, so lots of fun, new, easy tools to play around with in this section of HostGator. But for now, it's time to move forward with the main event of the tutorial and install your copy of WordPress. I think this should take us about 2 minutes. And after that, we'll learn as much as possible in WordPress as we can today. All right, and if not, got plenty more tutorials on the channel. So let's do it. Go ahead and come down to where it says get started with WordPress today and click that link. And now all we need to do is select your domain name from this list, which should be pretty easy unless you've made like a million WordPress sites like me. All right, there we go, there it is. And we're gonna leave the directory box blank, don't write anything there, and just click next. Now you need to enter some information like a blog title. So this can be changed later. I'm just going to go through quickly. The only thing you need to really focus on here is your email, because WordPress will send you some login details, and your admin user. This is what WordPress will understand as your username. So when you publish a blog post, it'll say published by whatever you write here, like Greg or, you know, tennis guy 22 or something. That's what it'll say. So make that one serious and good. All right, now check the terms box and click install now and cross your fingers. This is the famous WordPress one-click install you might have heard about. And we're doing it together. All right, success. We got the green check mark, installation complete. You do not want to click on the installation details. You just want to take these and copy them and put them someplace safe, like in a blank note file or a, you know, a Word doc. What you do want to do now is click My Installs, upper right, and change your password. All right, so let's load. It's thinking. We're going to come down to our new install at the bottom. Click Reset Password. You might just have one WordPress or, you know, a lot in the future. Choose your name and just write in new password. All right, so obviously I'll use something different. Click Update Password, and now let's click Admin Login. All right, so I just paused the video now to tell you three things. The first one is that if you visit your WordPress admin login link, like we are at right now, but you don't see this WordPress login, you see some sort of blank or error page, then it's either because when you just install WordPress, it can take between 2 and 4 hours for this screen to start working because your server and other servers in your area are updating to understand where your website is. Also, if you just connected your domain name from somewhere like GoDaddy to your hosting, it can take up to 72 hours to start seeing your website live because of what's known as propagation. That's just so you know, if you don't see this WordPress login screen, but you did follow the instructions, you probably didn't do anything wrong. Just take a break and come back a little bit later. The second thing I wanted to say is we're now going to start 10 steps to master WordPress in 10 minutes. I hope you'll stick with us because this is where we'll learn how to make a complete WordPress blog or website. Should be a lot of fun. And the third thing I wanted to say is we're going to get rid of the stopwatch because I think we want the full screen, but I'll just use that for my reference.